Hello world, this is Siraj. Welcome to this MacTex. In our last video, we discussed how to view, edit, print, save and delete documents. In this video, we are going to discuss how to do credit, case, part and full payments. So, let's get started. First, let's go to the menu and we'll click on the management. And if we go to the management, here we have this window. And I'm going to click on this payment types first. And let's see what are the payment types we have. Here we have case, Visa card, debit, check, voucher and credit. Okay. So in this video, we have to understand one thing. We can do case payment and credit payment. Okay, this credit payment is already set up, and here we can see credit, and here you can see the position. So this is the order that will be appeared when you are going to do the payment, and here we can do a couple of settings. Here, for example, if I click on this credit and if I click on this edit, I can see the settings here we have. Okay, the name of the payment, and we can give the code if we want, and also we can set up the shortcut key, and here we have to set the position. Okay, and here you can notice here this mark transaction as paid is turn off. Okay, so that's what it's treated as credit payment. Suppose if you want to create a new credit payment, you can create something like this. Here I'm going to click on the cancel, and here we have new payment type. You can click on this new payment type. Here we'll give the payment name credit sales. Okay, for example, and here we can set up the code and shortcut. Here I can set the position. You can click the plus, or you can type the number 7. Okay, the main thing you want to set up here, here we have mark transaction as paid. We have to turn off this. If you turn off this, all of the other settings will be set up automatically. And here, if you want to open the case drawer, you can set up this one. Otherwise, I don't want to open this one. So we will make it as off. Or sometimes if you are doing a part payment, that may helpful to open the case drawer. Okay, so we will turn on this one. So we can click save to save this payment type. So here you can see the credit sales will be appear as the 7th position. Okay, so if you don't want this, you can click on this delete button and you can click yes to delete. Here I have the credit payment already, so I can use this credit payment when I'm going to do the credit sales and purchase. Okay, so now we know here we have the payment type credit. If you don't have this credit payment type, you can create as I did earlier. So now we'll go to the documents, and here we already place some of documents like purchase and sales. Now we are going to do the payment. So I'm going to search some of documents like sales and purchase which were placed on a specific date. So we will click here period, and we will set up the date. So here I placed on July 30th as we done in our previous video. Okay, that's fine. Now we'll click search to get the document. So here I can see all of the documents that we have placed. Okay, here we have the purchase starting with 100 and stock return, sales, everything we have here. Okay, now we will do the payment. To do the payment, we can double click the one way you can double click, or else you can click the specific document, and we can click on this edit. Both are correct. Okay, so if I click on the documents and if I click on the edit, okay, the same documents will be open. Okay, and here we can do the payments. If we want to do the payment, here we have to click on this payments. Okay, so here we have the document types. Here we can see all of the details that we have placed on the 30th of July. Here we have the payment step. You can click on this payment steps. And here we have new button. Okay, we can click on this new. If you click on this new, the right side you will have this new payment dialog box. Here we have payment type. Here you can see the orders. Here you can see the orders that we have seen in the payment types. Okay, here we have cash, Visa card, debit card, check, vouchers, and credit. Okay, so now here I'm going to do a full cash payment. The first example, full cash payment. So we will make it as cash. Here, Aeronium point of sales automatically puts the total amount that we have to pay for this document. Okay, so since it's purchase, we have to pay. Here we can set the date. Okay, I'm going to give today date, and here we will click OK. Now you can see the payment type, date and amount, and I'm going to click on this paid. So we totally paid for this document purchase order. So we will click on this save. Okay, we'll click on this save. Okay, now we will close this one. Now we can see the purchase, this particular purchase order is paid. Okay, here we can see this particular document is paid by cash. Okay, now I'm going to do a part payment. Okay, means part of the total is going to be paid as a cash, and the rest of the amount will be credit. Okay, so here we'll click on this document purchase we have to pay, and we will double click. Okay, and now we can open this document. Here you can see all of the details that we have added earlier. Here we'll come to this payments. Okay, here as you can see earlier, here you can see new button. We click on this new, and here I'm going to select the default one, cash. So here Aeronium will put the total amount automatically. Here the total amount that we have to pay, 359,460. So for that, out of that, I'm going to pay 200,000 as cash. Okay, then we can click OK. Okay, that's fine. Now the total document total is 359,460, but we paid 200,000 as cash. Okay, if I click on this save button, Aeronium will pop up a warning message, invalid payment amount. Why? The payments amount must be equal to document total. Okay, please fix document payments and try again. So here you can see the document total is 359,460, but the paid amount is 200,000. Okay, so we have to do a correction. So here we paid 200,000, and the rest of the amount, 159,460, will be the credit. So we will click on this new button again, and here I'm going to change this credit. And here you can see Aeronium automatically puts the balance amount, balance figure, 159,460. That's fine. Now we will click OK, and now here we have the total amount is equal. Okay, here we have cash 200,000, credit 159,460. That's fine. Now we will click save. Now we can see document successfully saved. Okay, we will come to this view documents, and here we can see the payment, cash and credit. Okay, that's fine. Now we will receive the payments from the customers. Here we have the sales. Okay, now I'm going to receive the cash from this particular customer. So we will double click, and we'll go to the payments, and we'll click on the new, and here I'm going to receive the full cash. Okay, that's fine. Now we will click OK. Okay, and we'll click save button. That's fine. We'll go back to the view documents, and here we have paid. Okay, unpaid. Okay, so I forgot to turn to paid. If I right click on this document, here we have paid status, and here we have paid. Here also we can change the status, paid. That's cool. Here we have stock return. If you return the product to the supplier, they have to pay. So we have to receive the cash. So we will double click, and here we have the payments, and here the document total is 89,860. So I'm going to do the part payments. So here we will click on the new. I'm going to receive 50,000 as cash. Yeah, and the rest of the amount as credit. So we'll turn to this credit. Aeronium automatically puts the balance amount. So we'll click OK. Now we'll click on save. Okay, now we'll go back to the view documents, and here we have cash and credit. So like this, we can do full payment, full cash payment, part payment, cash and credit, and also we can make the credit payment. Okay, so that is the default setting. Like that, we have refund. Refund means customers return the product to our company, so we have to pay. We have to pay. So we will double click and we will click on the payments, and here we have new, and this is the amount that we have to pay, and here we will click OK. So I'm going to pay as a full payment. Okay, and we'll click OK. Then we'll click save. Okay, that's fine. Now we'll make it as full payment done, and we will click save, and we will go back to view, and here it is done. That's all I want to discuss in this video. If you have any queries, you can comment in the comment box. Hope you all have enjoyed this video. If you love this video, hit the thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel, click the subscribe button and don't forget to click the ring bell. Then you will be get notified to my brand new videos. Thank you very much, guys. We'll meet in the next video. Goodbye for now.